Okay, I am directly getting into the problem, then we'll try to understand. And here, before we go into the subject, friends, we can standardize our, first let me read the problem, then I'll give you the explanation. All of you ready? I Limited, a small engineering company, operates a job order costing system. It has been invited to tender for a comparatively large job which is outside the range of its normal activities. And since there is a surplus capacity, the management are keen to quote as low a price as possible. It is decided that the opportunity should be treated in isolation without any regard to the possibility of its leading to a further work of a similar nature. Although such possibility does exist, a low price will not have any repercussions on the ICE regular work. This, the cost estimate is done using the full cost method, absorption costing method. Direct materials and components, 2000 units of A at 25 rupees per unit, 200 units of B at 10 rupees per unit. Other materials and components to be bought. Direct labor, 700 hours of skilled workers, 1500 hours of unskilled workers. The overheads of department P, 200 hours at 25 per hour, and department Q, 400 hours at 20 per hour. Estimating department, 400 hours at 5 rupees per hour. Traveling, planning, total cost. The following information has been brought together. Material A, this is a regularly used stock item. The stock holding is more than sufficient for this job. The material currently held has an average cost of 25 per unit, but the current replacement cost is rupees 20 per unit. Material B, stock of 4000 units of B is currently held in stores. This material is slow moving and the stock is the residue of a batch bought 7 years ago at a cost of 10 per unit. B currently costs 24 per unit, but the resale value is only 18 per unit. A foreman has pointed out that B could be used as a substitute for another type of regularly used raw material, which costs 20 rupees per unit. The workforce is paid on time basis. The company has adopted a no redundancy policy, which means that skilled workers are frequently moved to jobs which do not make proper use of their skills. The wages included in the cost estimates are for the mix of labor which the job ideally requires. It seems likely if the job is obtained that all the 2200 hours of direct labor will be performed by skilled staff receiving 3.5 per hour. Overheads and department P, department Q and estimating department. So I hope you have the material with you, dear friends, so that I want you to read for 5 minutes, then I can explain you. You have the material with you? Okay, I'll just give you 3 minutes, you go through, I will explain. I'm not going to ask you any questions. Just like that, I'll finish. Giving you another 3 minutes. quickly read the problem. Okay friends, let us start the class. First I will start explaining everything and right, be ready. Fine. So are you all ready? I will explain, then if you read you will get a picture. When we look at this problem, you will realize that I will not ask any questions, I am just going on doing it. First step is, what is this problem? How do you know that we have to apply relevant costing? Generally it comes like that, normal cost sheet problem. But how do you think this is called relevant costing? What is relevant costing? Segregating the cost into two parts, that is avoidable and unavoidable cost, correct? No. So